Artists and others around the world are finding ways to show their solidarity with Ukrainians during this time of crisis. The efforts range from singing to light displays to prayers. Jeffrey Brown has a look for our Arts and Culture series, Canvas.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Ukrainian Chorus Dumka of New York.
Instead of laughter, as Saturday Night Live opened, a prayer for Ukraine, sung by the Ukrainian chorus Dumka of New York, whose members stood in front of candles and sunflowers, the Ukrainian national flower. Around the world, the response to the Russian invasion has taken many forms, some of it honoring Ukraine and its struggle, as in this London street performance of the national anthem by Ukrainian baritone Yuri Yurchuk.
Slava Ukraini!
Ukraine's blue and yellow colors were everywhere. New York and Dallas, Paris and Rome. Even the crashing waters of Niagara Falls. There were also punishments against Russia and Russians. In New York, Carnegie Hall canceled an appearance by renowned Russian conductor Valery Gergiev, a supporter of President Putin. And the Metropolitan Opera took a step to, quote, ring the alarm, General Manager Peter Gelb.
We can no longer engage with artists or institutions that support Putin or are supported by him, not until the invasion and killing has been stopped, order has been restored, and restitutions have been made.
In the pop culture space, the European Broadcasting Union announced Russia will not be allowed an entry in this year's Eurovision Song Contest, saying the inclusion of a Russian competitor would, quote, bring the competition into disrepute. Other such moves came fast and furious in the world of sports. British soccer fans from Liverpool and Chelsea came together to sing You'll Never Walk Alone in support of Ukraine. And European soccer's governing body announced it would move its championship match from St. Petersburg to Paris. Authorities in tennis, gymnastics, diving, skiing, auto racing, and other sports have taken their own actions. The International Judo Federation suspended Putin, a black belt in the martial art, as its honorary chairman. Meanwhile, in the Ukraine, artist Pavlo Makov, expected to represent his country at the prestigious Venice Biennale this spring, is instead sheltering with his family and practicing his shooting. And in Odessa's historic Brodsky Synagogue, a singing of a 19th century version of the ancient Jewish hymn Adon Olam, now a prayer for an end to the invasion. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown.
And in addition, the international free expression group PEN America will hold a vigil tonight in New York City.